What up, y'all? DC Fago guy. I finally got my package tonight, or today, I guess you could say, for the ICP's first six box set. As the title suggests, this is not an unboxing. I've already opened it. I've already went through it with my fiance. I decided to actually give a review on this. There's already been a couple of unboxings out there. I was honestly a little disappointed with Punk Rock Juggalos for Fago Lovers' first look at this. There wasn't really proper lighting. So I was very kind of disappointed. I didn't think the presentation was very good. Got mad love for Fago Lovers. Punk Rock Juggalo is an awesome fucking ninja. But that was very poorly presented. So I wanted to give my actual review on this. I've already reviewed five of the seven albums, or five of the eight albums, if you will, since this comes with a brand new EP. I've already dropped a review for five of them. So there's no need to really unbox it and show you it and be like, okay, I'm going to go listen to this and I'll give you a review later. I'll do that with the House of Wax EP. But as far as the actual box set, the main meat of what this is, we might as well just go ahead and do a review now. Give my thoughts on everything about it. So without further ado, we'll just jump right into this, okay? One thing I did save from the wrapping, this was on the front of it. It was up in the corner. How about I put it in view? I wanted to save that. I thought that was pretty cool. Yeah, I probably can't read it, but it's pretty cool. So I saved that. It also came with a holiday sticker. I've got another one of these now. That's fucking awesome. I think that is pretty awesome. Came with two more of these. I think I'm up to four or five of these now. I've got quite a few. But the thing I really wanted to show you that was cool is they have they had this little insert in there. I think that's what you would call these, right? An insert. Fucking awesome, right? Promote that new shit. So anyway, there's the front of this. Let's see how well I can get this. This thing was honestly bigger than I thought it was going to be. Giggity. It was. I wasn't sure the size of what I was going to be dealing with. So I'm trying to work around my tripod here a little bit. And I can't even see nothing. But here's one of the bottoms of it, and the top is exactly the same way. Got all the Joker cards on it, but then the side, I'm going to flip it around like this. Yeah, if you can read that, it's, there will be six faces of the Dark Carnival. After all six have risen, the end will consume us all. That's pretty awesome. So let's go ahead and flip her over and show you the back. It just has the different Joker cards and their track listings. And then over here it just says bonus CD House of Wax exclusive new album available only in this collection. And then it's got the release dates for the original, you know. And of course they had to put that shit on there. I think Sony, is it Sony or Universal that owns Island now? I don't even think Island exists anymore. I don't know. Oh, yeah, flip that back over without bumping anything. So we'll go ahead and we will open this up and take a look at what's on the inside. First off, got this little cardboard kind of envelope sleeve. And inside, you can only imagine, would be, I didn't even, what am I doing? I'm jumping ahead of myself. I didn't even, that right there, this is the sleeve. It says Insane Clown Posse, the first six. And on the back says, there will be six faces of the Dark Carnival. After all six have risen, the end will consume us all. Pretty cool. But we got the tarot cards in here, man. Look at that. Roman numeral one. Boom. Carnival of Carnage. And, if I'm not mistaken, this is the actual Carnival of Carnage story from within the book of the album. Ringmaster. Keep it moving, keep it moving. Riddle box. Great Malenko. Number four. You know, it gives their stories, which is pretty fucking dope. Amazing Jekyll Brothers. I've always thought that that split face was pretty fucking dope. I thought it'd make a badass tattoo. And the Wraith. So there's the tarot cards. I don't know, I thought about actually keeping these out and framing them, but I don't think I'm going to since they come with this fucking awesome sleeve, dude. They'll probably just stay in the box. I'm probably going to end up, I would have already had it pre-bought, but again, I didn't know how big this thing was going to be, but I want to get one of those plate holders, you know what I mean, where you put like antique plates on it, it comes out like this, and it's got the little things on the end so you can set a plate up against it. I'm probably going to buy one of those and actually just display this bitch. Comes with a certificate of authenticity, signed by Violent J and Shaggy 2 Dope. I'm probably going to laminate it just for protective purposes. I mean, because look, that bitch has already folded a little bit right there. Got a little rough handle in it. Either I did or somebody did. Something happened. But we'll laminate it. That'll help protect it. And then this is the full color book that they were talking about. I won't really go through and read this. Sometimes I do that in my reviews, but I'm not going to for this one. I read through it and my eyes are causing me problems tonight and giving me a headache. So I got all teary-eyed reading this, and my fiance is like, "Oh, you getting teary-eyed?" It's actually a very touching message. So I thought it was pretty cool. I don't know. Maybe I'll go back and read it. I don't know. We'll see. But on the inside here, you got basically some old school photos, just randomized completely. Of course, the message from Violent J, signed by Violent J. And then it's just going to go through, and he's going to basically tell kind of behind the paint style stories of each album. I bumped it. So there's Carnival of Carnage. And then we got Ringmaster. Ringmaster. Chuckle Brothers. And the Wraith, Shangri-La. And then the Wraith, Hell's Pit. Fucking Super Balls. And then in the back, you got all the tarot cards again with a butterfly, and it says this entire collection is dedicated to the butterfly. And then more of your pictures that are randomized. And then on the back we got a mirror image of the front. I see Insane Clown Posse logo from the Wraith. So we're gonna, well, I don't know why I'm doing that. We just, and then of course you got the fucking albums, right? And this is the original one. The only reason I'm pointing that out is because it has Night of the Axe and Black in Your Eyes. Whereas a re-release doesn't have that. And one thing I did point out to my fiance on this one, as I'm guessing this is original too, and the only reason I know that is because the one that I've got, the back is different. So I'm assuming this one that I've got is a re-release or a reissue. Doesn't matter. Has all the same songs. I'm not one of those hardcore collectors that's got to have that fucking original one. I just wanted the original Carnival of Carnage because it had two extra tracks that they had taken off. Of course, the Riddle Box. And the Great Malenko, which they gave me the purple one. I was hoping for the red one. I like the red one the best. I don't know why. I just feel like since that's usually the one they show, it's the one I want. So if there's anybody out there, Punk Rock Juggalo, anybody who has a red one, I will straight up trade you this sealed one for the red sealed one that came in your box set. Straight up swap and swap. Anybody out there, that's open to anybody. You know, you send me yours sealed, I'll send you mine sealed. You have my word. I would just rather have a red one in here because I'm going to leave all these sealed. I know I've said in the past I don't believe in really leaving them sealed. There's no point to it, but I do have all these albums except for House of Wax. That bitch is getting open and uploaded, but the rest of these are going to stay sealed in here for collective purposes. You know what I'm saying? Amazing Jekyll Brothers. Wraith Shangri-La. That wicked shit. Hell's Pit. And of course the House of Wax. Which I'm sure people have already watched the other unboxing, so I'm probably not showing that new, but I'll show it for no fucking reason. Track listings. Intro, Two Shot, I'm a Dickhead, The Zipper, 324, Zen of Love, Catch and Kill, featuring Big Hoodoo and Young Wicked, and Take It Out on Me. So, and actually, you guys are going to see a customization that I'm already going to do to this right now, because I'm going to take this out and leave it with my actual CDs. I'm actually going to stick in its place this. As I've said before, I bought this up, or picked this up and, from the... Let me start over. I picked this up from Best Buy thinking it had the Wraith Shangri-La and the Wraith Hell's Pit, the actual albums, just kind of a two-in-one thing. And when I popped it in and listened to it, it was all remixes. So I don't care for remixes, but I hung on to it for collective purposes. And so because of that, this is actually just going to right there in House of Wax's place. So... you know, that's pretty much it. That's it. Well, that's not pretty much it. That is it. That's everything that came in here. What was I getting ready to say? I don't remember. Let me gather my thoughts here for a second. I think this is fucking well presented. I love the way they put this together. I wasn't sure exactly how they were going to do it. That's kind of why I ended up caving in and watching Punk Rock Juggalo's unboxing of this, because I wasn't going to watch nobody's. I was going to wait. That way, you know, as I'm doing this review, I could kind of give my, oh, that's fucking awesome kind of responses, you know, get fucking raw shit like that. But I ended up caving and watching theirs because I just wasn't sure how they were going to have this all put together, and then the anticipation was killing me. Mine shipped Wednesday. And it said it was two-day shipping, which is bullshit. Fucking U.S. Postal Service. I didn't get it till today, Saturday. So, the one thing I always wondered that they were gonna, if they were gonna actually have the full CDs like that, or if it was gonna be, you know, the one thing I was almost expecting was kind of like when you get DVDs that have multiple ones and they're just stacked in there like that. You know what I'm saying? That's kind of one thing I was anticipating. Or even the ones that are like this, where they get the flippy deals and it's just the CD. There's no like booklets or nothing. I didn't know how they were going to do this. So the fact that they have the actual full CDs like that, saran wrapped and everything, like I can understand why it took so long to get this put together. So for everybody out there that was bitching about it, oh, when's it finally going to come out? That's kind of, you got to understand, that's, they went through a lot of loops, or they had to jump through a lot of rings of fire, kiss some ass probably, to get these so that they could put it together. And to those that are bitching about the price, this thing was $89.99 before shipping. So let's go ahead and think about that real quick. If you are lucky, you can find the CDs for $10. So there's seven of them right there. That's $70. You're already at 70. And how much do you think the fucking tarot cards would be worth if they just came out with a set of these? You know, this is good material. This is good, you know, this is good fucking, it's not cheap little, oh, they just printed out photo paper. You know, it's actually cardstock. And, you know, they went through this. The book is well put together. It's like really slick photo paper, I guess you could say. And even my fiance pointed out the detail right here. I mean, it has that marble look to it. The fact that the Joker cards on the siding and this right here on the siding, they put a lot into this and they're really proud of it. That's actually one of the things in that message from Violent J was outlining the fact that this was, I wouldn't say the highlight of their career, but one of their greatest achievements, and they're proud of it. And, you know, most Juggalos fell into the Juggalo world through the six Joker cards. So if you need a reason to pick this up, if you still need a reason, if they're not convinced, you know, fuck it. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to think of 17 reasons why you should pick this up. And I'll probably do a video over on Carnival Spirits, the top 17 reasons of why you should pick up the first six box set. So be on the lookout for that. Also, Panic 17's planning on doing an unboxing when he gets his. Hopefully he'll get his very soon. The anticipation killed me. So be on the lookout for his video as well as mine. You can get his opinions and his thought on this as well. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys.